Hello future engineers, welcome to my YouTube channel. If you're still new to my channel and you like what I'm doing, please don't forget to share my videos to your friends and to your friends' friends. That's the only way you can keep me going, refreshed and inspired. Also, if my videos are important to your studies, don't forget to subscribe. This problem was already solved by the force method. Let's solve this again by the method of least work. So determine the bar force of member AD, AE is constant. In the force method, we found out that this is indeterminate to the first degree, statically stable and indeterminate to the first degree. R is 3, bar 6, joints 4. So 3 plus 6 is greater than 2 times 4. So that's why this is statically stable and indeterminate to the first degree. Let us select AD as our redundant force. And we will denote that by P. There are 6 members. Take note. So the slope of CD, which is the slope of AD, is 4.5 divided by common to 4.5 and 1.8 is 0.9. So 4.5 over 0.9 is 5. 1.8 divided by 0.9 is 2. So same slope as AD. Then the slope of AB, which is slope of BC, 4.5 over 0.3 is 15. Common to 4.8 also, 4.8 over 0.3 is 16, and the hypotenuse square root of 81. So for the reactions, summation moment at C0, Ay times 9 plus 90 times 4.8 equals 150 times 4.5, you'll get 27 kilonewtons here at C, that 123 kilonewtons. So verify that by statics, of course, horizontally at A, 90 kilonewtons to the left. So at D, summation forces horizontal equals 0. SCD times 5 over square root of 29 equals P times 5 over square root of 29. So SCD is P. I should not do the statics anymore, but since I started it, so I'll just apply statics anyway. The solution can be fitted in this one screen. But next time around, I will assign to you the statics anymore because this is structural theory. There will be no learning if I keep on presenting the statics part without you doing something in statics. That's the only way you can master statics, if you do the statics themselves. Do not just watch the videos and keep on nodding your head because you can follow. You should perform yourselves. That's the way you can improve yourselves in structural theory. So summation forces Y, so SVD equals 2 times P, vertical components of P times 2 over square root of 29, then plus 150. So SVD is 4P over square root of 29 plus 150. Then we proceed to joint C, summation forces Y first, or vertical equals 0. So SBC times 16 over square root of 481 plus P times 2 over square root of 29 plus 123 equals 0. So SBC is equal to negative 0.5091 P and minus 168.6. Summation forces horizontal to the left, positive SAC plus P times 5 over square root of 29 plus quantity negative 0.5091 P minus 168.6 times 15 over square root of 481 equals 0. So SAC is equal to negative 0.5803 P plus 115.312. Finally, at A, summation forces vertical SAB times 16 over square root of 481 plus P times 2 over square root of 29 plus 27 equals 0. So SAB is equal to negative 0.5091 P minus 37.010. So that's it. It's your job to perform checking at A, summation versus X, if it is 0, and then proceed to B. You also check summation versus x 0 and if summation versus y is also 0. So let's tabulate. We have member, partial, we have the stress, S in kilonewtons, partial of S with respect to P, which is member AD, P is member AD, stress of AD, length in meters, then the product. Then, in alphabetical order, we have AB first, which is negative 0.5091P minus 37.010, the partial derivative with respect to P, negative 0.5091, the length of AB is square root of 4.5 square plus 4.8 square, so that's 6.5795 meters. Then the product, so that's a product. Then AC is negative 0.5803P plus 115.212, the partial derivative with respect to P, negative 0.5803. Then the length of AC is 9, then the product 3.0307P minus 602.24. Then AC, then we have AD, which is P, derivative 1, length square root of 4.5 square plus 1.8 square, so that's 4.8466 meters, so the product 4.8466P. Then BC, negative 0.5091P minus 168.6, partial derivative, negative 0.5091, then the length is same as this, AB, 6.5795, the product 1.7053P plus 564.75. Then BD, which is 4P over square root of 29 plus 150, the partial derivative 4 over square root of 29, the length is 3 in the figure, and the product 48OP over 29 plus 34.25. And lastly, CD, it is P, so derivative 1, length is same as AD, 4.8466P, so 4.866P the product. So adding summation of S, partial of S with respect to P, times length is equal to 17.79P plus 420.73. So the internal work done, because this is least work, summation of S, partial of S with respect to P, length over AE is 0 because AD is an internal force. So remember the principle in statics or in dynamics that the internal work done by an internal force is 0. So equate to 0, so AE does not matter, so P is negative, so it is in compression. So S P is SAD equals 23.65 kilonewtons compression. So that's it for this problem.